I just got back from CES, and a bunch of new things were announced, including smart TVs, smart rings, and AI in everything. But what I'm most excited about are smart glasses. Let's dive in. Before we talk about the glasses which were there at CES, I want to quickly remind you of what kind of smart glasses have existed over the years. The first one was Google Glass, which uses a prism display to show me content at the top of my eye. The second one was the Bird Bar display, which has been used by companies like Xreo. They show me immersive content, but have very little light passing through. The third kind was what we saw in Even Realities, which is the waveguide display. It is an embedded display within the lens and can show me content because of the projector on the left or right. The fourth kind, which is so new, is direct projection onto my retina. So we'll see some of these in the CES review for us today. We saw companies trying to use the waveguide technology in various forms and fashion, and only one of them using the retina projector. The first one we'll talk about is Captify. This is a startup which is trying to do a pair of glasses for people who can't hear properly and are only developing it for the accessibility use case. They have a waveguide which is in front of me. It's actually not as wide as the Even Realities G1, but it is taller than that. They are a regular pair of glasses which have speakers inside them, also no cameras, and are mainly focused on having a higher quality microphone, which can do beamforming for people who can understand what's happening around them. So they're mainly focused on captions and not so much on the day-to-day wear. They don't look like a regular pair of glasses. They look like technology on your face, but that's something which they are incredibly focused on. I did not see the app that they had. I was only able to look at the pair of glasses in front of me. They say that they have all-day translation and all-day transcription, and you can actually eventually look at the app and the translations within the app, but I did not see that. They did not mention AI at all, and they were only focused on captions. In some cases, they did mention that they were running a local model for those translations, but I wasn't sure whether that local model was running on the phone or on the glasses. I don't think it was running on the glasses. It was most likely running only on the phone, and everything was over Bluetooth only. They also use two waveguides in each of the eyes so that you get depth perception in your text, but they did not mention anything else like the Even Realities G1 or G1B does right now. They are not shipping. They are planning to start shipping in April, and I think they start somewhere from $599 to $899. They did not mention why that price differential was present, and also they only have one style of glasses right now. I would not recommend that you buy these. Next pair was Halliday. If anyone has seen Ready Player One, the name Halliday came out from Halliday, who was the creator in Ready Player One, and this is inspired by that. They're actually doing a new technique of how you can actually have a display in front of your eyes. They're actually trying to project something in my eyes, and you'll see that they have a tiny little projector which can be moved around left and right, up and down, to get the right positioning for your eye. You can focus by moving, rotating the projector so that you can refocus for your eyes and your prescription. So one interesting thing about Halliday is that you can actually work with a regular optician because there is nothing on the screen. These are regular lenses. You can get transition lenses if you want to, but it doesn't matter which optician you go to. The glasses are a regular pair of glasses, on top of which we have this projector which can display content to you. Interesting concept. I like where they're headed, but I don't think that they're at the point where it can be used day to day. They do seem clunky to me because you still need to look up and look up a lot to actually see the content. It's not in front of you. I would love to see better placement and projection into my eye rather than having to look up all the time to be able to read my content, because it can become incredibly tiresome. The cool thing about them is that they also come with a ring. So you can actually use the ring to control what's being presented in front of you rather than having to tap on the stem or rather than touch your glasses at all. It does not have a camera. It does have a microphone, And they are also touting proactive AI, which essentially would show me information within my context when I'm having a conversation. So if someone asks me a hard question and I'm struggling to answer that, it would show me the answer right in front of my eyes so that I can still stay in the moment while almost seeming more knowledgeable. They're not shipping right now. They're planning on doing a Kickstarter in March. I am excited for the technology and what they're doing. They have a different approach and they come with a ring, which is a very cool input method because now I don't need the phone to be always present. The cool thing which I saw because of the projector was the incredibly high refresh rate so that the content could come up very quickly and seamlessly. They were actually playing a video in that little projector. I believe they have a few frames, but they only had one on display for me to try on. And that's the one which you see here. Next is Mustard Glasses. To be honest, I don't know if I can actually even call this one out because they don't have a pair of glasses to sell. They don't have an app. They have a dev kit which they're selling, and all of their videos which they have on their site felt like they produced it only for CES. Their documentation is missing. I tried connecting to buy a pair, but I actually could not do that. So it feels like they came in to CES to actually validate if this idea could potentially work or not. The glasses themselves, at least what I learned from the founders, they don't have a pair, they don't have a screen. It's almost like a Meta Ray-Ban Plus, which has inbuilt voice AI. If you want Mustard, don't go for the Meta frames and use that because they are much more reliable. They're coming in from a well-known brand, Ray-Bans, and you get access to AI. Yes, we don't like what Meta is doing, but as a physical product, the Meta Ray-Bans are far superior to what the Mustard glasses present to us right now. Next up is Xandr. So Xandr is like a premium version of the Captify that we saw. They're only focused on transcription and translation. The cool thing about this is that the model actually runs on the glasses. It's not running on the phone, which is connected. So you get incredibly fast local translation and transcription. They say that they support 40 languages. We were only able to test English captions for the glasses at CES. They don't make the hardware. They only do the software. The hardware is actually a repurposed Vizio eyewear glasses, a Vizio AR headset, which is being used. And I would not recommend getting these unless you are looking at some industrial application. These guys are most likely selling as a B2B application for elderly homes or other places who are hard of hearing and want captions in their day-to-day because the price tag that they have is $5,000. The Vizio glasses are $2,500 and they're charging another $2,500 markup on top of it to actually give you that software. I would highly not recommend that you buy any of these. Finally, we look at Moji. So Moji is interesting because they're coming out with a waveguide solution which is multicolor. I did not get a chance to try these. They were mostly speaking in Chinese and not in English. It was very hard for me to understand them, and it was very hard for me to find a person who could actually tell me exactly what was going on. What I've seen from this site, they have been around at CES every single year for the past few years. However, I am not able to buy a pair of Moji glasses even right now. I tried buying a pair. They don't ship to Canada. Maybe this year that'll change and I will be able to try a Moji pair of glasses with multicolor waveguide tech. So what do I think? Well, I think it's an incredibly amazing time for anyone who wears glasses. We have so many companies actually fighting for space on my face. There are so many companies who I did not talk about. These were just the startups who were coming out with smart glasses. I can't wait for more information to be presented to me in context, while coming in from an approach which is more eyewear centric or eyewear first. I don't want a piece of tech on my face. I want a pair of glasses which also have tech. I want the device to seamlessly blend into my day to day rather than coming in as a piece of technology which I have to wear, not want to wear.